That you'll ever do. Two can be as bad as one. It's the loneliest number since the number one. No is the saddest experience you'll ever know.
I'd like to explain why I came up with Math Magic Blocks. It was 1982, and one day, just in a flash of insight, I realized, whoa, this is possible. Well, I had laid the groundwork for that insight many years earlier. When I was in elementary school, in the fourth grade, my mom came in for her annual parent conference, and Mrs. Blum was a little upset. She was worried about me because, as she explained, sometimes Bruce just wanders around the playground during recess. He doesn't play with the other children. My mom was understandably worried. I mean, she didn't want to have some loner geek for a son. But she didn't need to worry for long because shortly thereafter, I sprung the following mathematical sleight of hand upon the whole family at the dinner table. So, here's the way it works. In fact, I'd like to do some cyber sleight of hand with you now. I have a card, and it says nothing on it right now. But I'm going to write a number, and I'm not going to show you the number, on this card. And then I'm going to take it, and I'm going to fold it in half. And once it's folded in half, I'm going to place it inside the envelope, and then seal the envelope. Now, I'll put it here for safekeeping. And now, if you'll follow me with a little mathematical series here, I'd like you to pick a number between 5 and 10. Got it? Okay. Multiply by 9. Now you have a two-digit number. So please take those two digits and add them together. Now, take the square root of that result. And to that result, add 30, and to that result, subtract 5. And now I need to feel the cyber vibes, and yes, I know what number you're thinking of. In fact, it's perfectly obvious what number you're thinking of, because you're thinking of a perfect number, and that it is. Now, you might not know that that's a perfect number, but ancient mathematicians defined perfect numbers as follows. Perfect number is a number that the sum of its factors equals the number. So, for example, let's take 6. 6 has as factors 1 and 2 and 3. Well, 1 plus 2 plus 3 equals 6. And how about 28? Well, the factors of 28 are 1 and 2 and 4, and 7, and 14. Well, if you add 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 4 is 7, plus 7 is 14, plus 14 is 28. So 28 is also a perfect number. Well, the reason I'm telling you this is because I've been in love with math for a long time. It's so beautiful. It's so much fun. I remember getting Scientific American magazine, which was way beyond my level to understand in general. But there was a section at the end by a guy named Martin Gardner. It was called Mathematical Recreations. And every month, I would devour it because he had all these quirky, fun ways of looking at the world through numbers. Donald in Mathmagic Land was brought up by Walt Disney in the early 60s. And I just loved that show. Well, I don't think that too many kids love the show that they get in their math class each day. They seem to be kind of, well, math is a subject that they know one thing about, and that is maybe two things. They're not good at it and they don't like it. They come together. But math needn't be like that. And the reason I invented Math Magic Blocks is because I would like kids to have at least one experience of finding math so compelling and so exciting that they gotta do it. I have given some sets of Math Magic Blocks to various teacher friends, and they report that the kids, they can't stay away. In fact, one of my friends who has a set sent me a little photograph of one of his kids. It was Christmas time, and they were writing Dear Santa letters. And one kid wrote, "Dear Santa, for Christmas I would like a tablet and Math Magic Blocks." Oh, how cute can you get? And that, I think, makes me very happy, because it means that there's hope that when kids get a chance to play with this game, they may think twice about rejecting math as being something that they like or are good at, because they get a chance to actually get good by doing math instead of just memorizing math for a test. That's why I invented Math Magic Blocks.